communication is currently very difficult. Telephone lines are down. The electricity has been cut off, making charging mobile phones difficult. So it's really impossible actually to communicate with anybody and even figure out what is going on. You just can't get through. All the phone lines are down. And the electricity has been cut off. The water is also cut off. So you can imagine right now what would be happening there with no water, no electricity, no phone calls. The number of people killed is continuing to rise. In the morning, we heard 100. By midday, it was 500. Right now, it's 1,000 and rising. Many of the old houses have been destroyed. And at least one large apartment block has come down in Kathmandu. Given the closeness to the epicenter, Pokhara must also be affected, badly affected. I think we have several friends of Oxfam who take part in trail walkers and so on, who were climbing, some friends actually climbing Mount Everest, some others who had just left for a trek today. So we've been monitoring their safety. At the moment, what we know is at least our immediate staff and families and friends are safe. But Pokhara must be badly affected. Oxfam is preparing to help provide clean water and emergency food. People are gathered in their thousands in open spaces and are scared of going back into their homes, as there have been several aftershocks.